All right, so hopefully you have already watched the video for Math Antics. If you haven't, I would suggest that pause this one and go watch that one first. That goes over what all of these weird words mean. It might not have range. It does talk about a little bit, now that I remember. But it mainly goes over mean, median, and mode. It's very important to know what those mean. I'm not going to go too much in depth with it, but I am going to make some notes on here that you might want to make on your own paper. These four measures of spread are very important when we're dealing with data sets. So whenever there's a survey occurring, whenever you're trying to find certain answers. So like right now we're doing a bunch in eighth grade of end of the year boards, and they're all voting on different people. So I'm using the mean, median, and mode to kind of determine who gets which award. You use it without thinking a lot of the time once you understand what it is and how to use it. They're all pretty easy as long as you can understand the difference. The hard part is they all start with M, except that last one. So the mean, median, and mode are really the main ones we're going to look at. The range is very easy. Range is just the differing numbers that you could have, so from your smallest number to your largest. So let's start with mean. Mean is your average. It is what is the average number that occurs. So mean is as simple as it's your average. To find your mean, what you do is, that's the bottom maybe. So for mean, we know it's your average. And to find it, you add up all the numbers. So you find your total. Then you divide the total by the amount of numbers. So that'll make more sense once we start doing it. You might remember from Math Antics when he was going over it. Let's look at the first one. Okay. These are our data sets. We have 11, 15, 11, 10, 15, 10, 9, and 15. With anything like this, maybe it's a blurry. Hold on. With anything like this, you can always use a calculator. You're going to be dividing by big numbers. You're going to be adding different things, finding different things in it. For mean, I think it's easiest to always use a calculator. I'm going to show you don't have to. The main thing you gotta do is you have to add all these numbers. So I usually start by adding two at a time. So 11 and 15, we get 26. 11 and 10, you get 21. 15 and 10, you get 25. And 9 and 15, you would get 24. Okay? Then you're gonna add them, keep going. You could do it this way if you would like. You would get 47. Here you would get 49. And then at the end you do 49 plus 47 and you would get 96. So your total is 96. And you are going to, sorry, I didn't realize that was blurry. You are going to divide by how many numbers do you actually have. And to do that, you're counting. Here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have 8 total numbers, so when I do 96 divided by 8. Okay, so 96 divided by 8, and when you divide it, you would get 12. Okay, so that is the mean, meaning the average number that would appear based on this data is 12. If you think about the number 12, it's kind of in between all these numbers. It's lower, your biggest number is 15, your smallest number is 9. It's really pretty much in the middle of those numbers. It's always going to be somewhere within that data set. It's not going to be like 38, because 38 would not be an average of these. But for all of these, you're going to find your number, and it would mean what number is in between. If you don't want to add them like this, you can easily take your calculator and do 11 plus 15 plus 11 plus 10 plus 15 plus 10 plus 9 plus 15. The main thing, if you're adding it this way, is to maybe add them twice to make sure you get the same answer. So I got 96, that is correct. And then you could easily do dividing by 8. And you would get 12. So you can easily use a calculator. I typically do. I was just showing you, if you don't have a calculator on hand, it's still possible to do all of this. Your number's not always going to be a whole number. Sometimes you're going to get a decimal. Sometimes you're going to have fractions you're dealing with. That will all start next year. The decimals, it'll just be a number divided by something else that's not a whole number. So that's okay to get a decimal. Just write the whole thing out. So like if it's 12.5, you'd write 12.5. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to keep up with mean, and then we're going to come back and do median after. So let's keep up with mean, but let's look at this next one. Okay, we know the mean is our average. We know that we have to find our total. So when we find that, you have to add all these numbers together. You could do it in two ways. If you want to add up top, if you want to add with the calculator, go ahead and find what is the total amount. Okay, so hopefully you either added it. I believe you should get 84. I'm going to check actually real quick, with checking it up top in case you're doing it this way. 16 and 14, that would be 30. 15 and 15, that would be 30. 11 and 13, that would be 24. This would be 60 plus 24. You should get 84, and that is correct. Okay? So we have 84, but we need to divide it by our amount that we have. So then you need to count your numbers. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 numbers. 84 and divided by 6. It is a whole number, but if you don't know it at the top of your head, you can always get a calculator and divide it. That works too. The main thing here is not checking your math facts, although you should always be working on those. It's making sure that you understand what the numbers mean. When you do 84 divided by 6, you get 14. Okay. Now, if you look, 14 is in the middle of all these. It's not bigger than any number. It's not smaller than the smallest. It kind of seems like it would be what it should be. Okay. We're going to do two more kind of together where you guys are working on them. I want you guys to go ahead and try this one. Find the means. You need to find your total, so go ahead, pause the video. Find your total, and then divide by how many numbers you get. So if you have not yet paused, because I'm going to start going over the answer. Alright, when you add them together, 10 plus 13 plus 8 plus 17 plus 7, when you add all these up, your total is 55. That means you do 55 and you divide by how many numbers I have. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 numbers. And you should know off the top of your head, 55 divided by 5 is 11. So hopefully you guys got that one right. Once you do a couple, it gets pretty simple. All right, if we look at the next one, I want you guys to go ahead, pause this, and find the mean of this data set right here. If you haven't yet, go ahead and pause, because I'm going to go over the answers. To find the mean, you add them all up, so 19 plus 20 plus 7 plus 18 plus 11, you should get 70. 5, and you would divide by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 75 divided by 5, you would get 15. So 15 is your mean. The main thing you're checking is you're not getting a number like just leaving it as 75. That's way too big. 15 fits in this data set. 11 fits in that data set. That is how you know you are on the right track. Okay? Well, now we're going to go back up to the top, and we're going to work on median. Median is one of the harder ones, I think. Certain problems are hard, certain problems are easy. The first two are actually going to be pretty simple. Bottom two are going to be a little bit more work, but that's okay. The main reason we do mean first is because sometimes to find the median, you do need to find the mean, okay? The main thing you need to do is you need to put them in order from least to greatest. So for median, you always take your smallest number first, and then you go down the list. Now, the best way to not forget any numbers and making sure you're actually going from least to greatest is, after you do this, I typically cross them off. So I'm going to go through my list and say my lowest number is 9. Okay? I'm going to cross off 9, and I'm going to write 9. Okay? Now I'm going to go, do I have any more 9s? No more 9s. Then my next number, I see the next lowest number is 10. So I'm going to cross off 10. Once you cross it off, you know you've used it. And I'm going to go, is there any more 10s? I'm going to see one right here. So you're going to write it again. If there's more than one, you write it twice. Then you're going to keep going. Okay, then I see an 11. You can put commas in between if you want to. I see another 11. Okay, no 12s, no 13s, no 14s. I see a 15. I see another 15. And I see another 15. Okay? You could start with median if you wanted to, because you're just putting them in order. You're not changing any numbers. You're just changing the order of them, and that doesn't really affect anything. It's always helpful to have them from least to greatest, because then it lets you see other things as well. Okay? So with median, you're trying to find what is the number in the middle is. Okay? So when you're doing that, I think it says backwards. The first two are a little bit more tricky than the bottom two. The bottom two are pretty simple. If you have an even number here, it might be a little harder. If you have an odd number, it's always one answer. It's very constant if that's your median. Now, to find the median, you have them all in order. Every number up top is crossed off. This is where you're going to have to cross off again. Now, I'm not scribbling it out. I'm just putting a slash through it so I can still see what number is behind it. In case you ever make a mistake, you can rewrite something because you know what number it still is. When you find the median, you take one off on the left, and I go all the way to the right, and I take the other number off. I'm trying to make my way to the middle. Now, you might already see what it is. When you have data sets that have like 30 numbers in it, it's way harder. So, I've been doing this for, I don't even know, a long time, and I still cross them off no matter if I'm dealing with 3 numbers or I'm dealing with 42 numbers. I still cross them off till I get to the center point. Okay, I cross one off on the right, then I go back to the left, then I go to the right. I have 2 on both sides crossed off. Go left, I'm going to go to the right. Okay? Now is where you see you'll either have 1 number left or 2 numbers left. If you have more than 2 numbers, you've got to keep going. Here, I have 2 numbers. They're not always going to be the same. It just so happens that this is the same. Whatever number is in the middle is your median, so 11 is our median. Now, you have 2 numbers. If they are not the same, the method you do is you find the mean of these. So you add them together. Then you divide by 2. So if they were not both 11, it still works even if they are both 11. You do 11 plus 11. You get 22, and then you divide by 2, and you would get 11. So it's the same thing. It's just one extra step in place. When you have decimals, it gets harder. Use a calculator. That's fine. We're going to see on the next one where we're actually going to get stuck with different numbers in the middle, and we'll have to work them out. So the median here is 11. They're both 11. If you ever have more than 2 numbers, you need to keep going until you're at 2 or 1. So then let's look on this side. To find the median, you got to put them in order from least to greatest. I'm going to use the same color, so it's similar. I'm going to go find my smallest number. My smallest number is 11. Cross it off. Then I'll look. Any more 11s? There's no more 11s. Then I go 12. No 12s. But I do see a 13. Cross it off. Then I see a 14. Then I see a 15. Then I see another 15. Then I see a 16. They are all crossed off. I'm going to double check I have the same amount. I should have 6. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now you're going to take one side, cross off. Cross one on the left, one on the right. One on the left, one on the right. I'm left with a 14 and a 15. That means that you would have to do 14 plus 15, and then you would have to divide by 2. Now, when you do 14 plus 15... show you guys over here. Maybe. You would get 29, and then you would divide by 2, and you would get 14.5. That means your median is a decimal. That is okay. Your median is 14.5. Alright, let's look at this one. I want you guys to try this one on your own. Put them in order from least to greatest, then pause the video. Alright, when you put them in order, median, the smallest number, if you haven't done it, pause the video and actually solve it for yourself. I'm going to start going over it. The smallest number I see is a 7. Then I see an 8, then I see a 10, then I see a 13, then I see a 17. It's so important to cross them off when you're done. That way you know that you've actually used that number. If you forget to cross it, you might write it more than once, and then you're going to get a different answer. Okay? When you do this, you cross one on the left, one on the right, one on the left, one on the right, and left with one number. That is your median. It's easier if it's an odd number you're dealing with of data points. Because you're going to get one number, you don't have to add anything and divide. It's that's the median. And then let's try this last one as well. Go ahead, pause the video and solve this one, and then I'm going to go over it once you guys have solved it. Restart the video because I'm going to start going over it now. You find your smallest number. My smallest number is a 7. My next smallest is an 11. My next smallest is an 18. Then I have a 19, and then I have a 20. You're going to go across off. One left, one right. One left, one right. You're left with 18 is your middle number. Now, you might see that these numbers are pretty similar. 10 and 11 are pretty close. 18 and 15 are kind of close. 14 and 14.5 are close. 12 and 11 are close. You're always going to try and make sure your numbers are kind of close together. If they're not, that means that there is some random number in this data set that is causing these differences. They don't have to be the same. They're typically not going to be the same. You're measuring different things, but you're still measuring where the center would be. All right, so we've done mean, we've done median. Those are the harder two. The next two are very simple. For mode, all mode is mode means the most. You should probably write our notes at the bottom. We have median is our middle number. Mode, I started writing most, is the most. What number do you see the most? Now, if you put them in order and you've already found your median, you know which number you've seen the most. So then the easiest way is to do your median first and then you see. Okay, I have 1, 9. I have 2 10s, so 10 right now appears more. 2, 11, so 10 and 11 would be my mode. But then 15, I have 3 of them. 15 appears the most, and that's why my mode is as simple as writing the number you see the most, 15. Okay, go ahead and look at the next one and see which number do you see the most. Alright, if you're looking at all of these, the number I see the most is 15. I see it twice, no other number I see that much, so my mode is 15. It looks like a 16. 15. Okay? Let's look down here. This one's a little tricky, because if I look, I don't have any number that I see more than once, but there's always a mode. Okay, as long as you have a number, there's a mode. Now, the most that occurs is 1. That means that I have a bunch of modes. My mode is going to be every number, 7, 8, 10, 13, 17. It's okay to have way more than one mode. You typically won't have this, but sometimes you will. You would just write every number that appears the same amount. So if you have two numbers that appear twice, both of those numbers are your modes. And the same thing over here. They all appear once, so they would all be my mode. You could write them in any order you want. I just rewrite them because they're already in that order above. All right, so those three, hopefully they make sense. And let's look at range, and then we will be all done. All right, for range. Range is as simple as you take your biggest number and you subtract your smallest number. So, the biggest number I see on this one, you go to your end of the median is 15, so it'd be 15. And you go to the other end of the median, which is 9. 15 minus 9, and my range would be 6. That means I cover 6 different data sets potentially in this picture. Okay, let's try the next one. My biggest number is a 16. My smallest number is an 11. 16 minus 11 is 5. My range is 5. And let's try the last field. My biggest number here is 17. My smallest number is 7. And that would cover 10 different data sets. And the last one, go ahead and do it real quick. My biggest number is 20. My lowest number is 7. 20 minus 7 would give me 13. All right, so we've gone over all 4 of the main data sets. If you have other questions and you want more in-depth things on them, I can do way more. I don't want to waste your time, though. You now have 2 at the bottom you can finish. And then on the other page, you have 6. So you now have 8 you can do on your own, and we've just done 4. We've taken them much slower. You could do them all in one sitting, so like do mean, median, mode, and range on this one, and then go to the next one and do the same thing. You don't have to do mean on all of them. However you find works best for you. And then next week, we will be going over day 12, because that's the last new topic we have to cover. Have a great rest of your week, and start to your week next week, and I'll see you guys on Wednesday. Bye.